We've seen them hunt down terrorists in Afghanistan, unmanned aircraft, commonly known as drones. And they could soon fill the skies right here at home.
Congress has directed the Federal Aviation Administration to open the airways for commercial use of drones by 2015. New tonight, KATV News Watch 7's Andrew Ozaki gives us a glimpse into the future.
You are looking at what soon could be hovering into our everyday lives, flying robots or drones. This one was developed by University of Nebraska researcher Vishal Singh.
I think we're going to start seeing this in a lot of everyday situations.
He can control it with a joystick or even program an automatic flight plan. Stabilize cameras, relay back a bird's eye view. He's already used the craft to help researchers study crops at the university.
So, you know, which areas of fields need to be watered more.
Right now, the Federal Aviation Administration only allows university researchers like Singh or government agencies to fly drones over American soil. They've issued 300 permits. The Mesa County Sheriff's Office in Colorado has one. Nebraska law agencies say it's definitely on their radar screen.
I wouldn't be surprised if 10 years from now, you see news organizations or police departments that could never afford to keep a helicopter in the air using unmanned vehicles to bring back a video feed.
Recommendations for rules on commercial use, like for realtors or news organizations, could come out as soon as this spring.
This year is the year we're going to start to see what the rules are going to be and what the future is going to hold.
Matt Wade is a journalism professor at UNL. He sees the promise of this new technology.
Throw them in the trunk of your car, you go out to a story, you go up, you get your images, you come down, you send them back to the newsroom.
And its concerns.
I think you are a little bit naive if you think this is cool and you don't realize that it is a little bit creepy.
He set up a drone journalism lab to research the legal and ethical issues of privacy in this brave new world. His webpage offers a forum for information and debate.
When do you use it? And when is the use of a drone a violation of somebody's privacy?
And there's questions about safety. Right now, drones can only be flown under 400 feet and within eyesight.
There is a great deal of responsibility that comes with trying to use these in a public place around people.
Still, the benefits, like helping police track down a suspect or a missing person, allowing a farmer to quickly assess crop damage after a storm, or helping journalists give their viewers new eye-opening perspectives, could soon be on the horizon.
Once it's allowed for commercial purposes, I could see this really taking off.
In Lincoln, Andrew Ozaki, KETV, News Watch 7.
Drones have a wide-ranging cost between hundreds and tens of thousands of dollars. Researchers also tell us you'll see the technology a lot more once the FAA approves commercial use.